Excellent entertainment.
Now, where are you folks from today? We're from Tama United Methodist Church. We're on a mission trip.
A mission trip? Well, isn't that nice? You look like you have a lot of mission.
They're on a trip with a mission, Dad.
Actually, we're taking a day to sightseeing and hopefully hear about the most wild and courageous heroes ever to live on the glorious and majestic Nile River.
Well, if you come to the right place, you'll be entertained, dazzled, and mystified by the stories we will tell you on the Nile. You have three options for the entertainment portion of our cruise. Liza?
That's right, you may choose between
crazy animal fields in the Nile,
lots of rich
and famous,
or ancient heroes of the Nile.
We'll take ancient heroes of the Nile, please.
An excellent choice. You've chosen the entertainment option that is in my favorite genre, chiptunes.
Ooh.
Let's begin our entertainment portion of the cruise with the story of Joseph.
Oh, I think I know this one.
Joseph was a shepherd boy, his father loved him so. And he gave his son a special coat, but his sisters, they knew he'd have to go.
Sisters?
Yes, sisters. May I continue?
Yes, sorry.
God gave Joseph dreams, that one day will come true. Joseph wanted to follow him, and that's what he
wanted. All my clothes are gray, my sisters and me. All of a sudden, my clothes are thin, yours are not to me. Sorry.
Well, you know, I'm pretty sure Joseph and the Bible had two brothers.
Oh, I'm pretty sure it was sisters.
Absolutely.
I think so.
Sisters, not brothers. Fix it, people. Let's try it again.
You're my brothers and gray, my brothers and me. And all of a sudden, my girls are big, girls are bad to me.
God, I know some dreams, I they will come true. Joseph and I are falling. Joseph went to see his brothers and their flocks, with no idea their relationship was really They saw him at a distance and their hearts are in despair.
Sorry, let's get rid of him.
Much better. They tricked their father, Jacob. They told him Joseph was gone. They sold him to the Israelites, which brings us to the end of the song. Keep going. You and some hero sister of Joseph keychains or posters? No? Oh, why don't you just introduce the next act?
Slavery, and Pharaoh had them sighing and crying.
Interrupting?
We promise we won't say a word.
Places, everyone. I now present the story of Pharaoh and the plagues.
This is song dedicated to my slaves, the Israelites. They've been with me for a long time, but no matter how much they get on my nerves, I just can't let them go.
Pharaoh, it's your land back.
work this out.
I need some time to center.
Wait, Dad, don't leave. You're the one. You're the only one who can drive the boat.
Then maybe you'll appreciate me more when I'm gone. The show's canceled.
Oh, no. Oh, must stay in control. The show must go on. The show must go on. Oh, who am I kidding? We've been trying to stay in business for so long. Without our hero stories, I'm afraid we won't have any customers. It's over.
Well, we could tell you some stories, and they're true.
Are they hero stories?
Well, really, in all the stories, God is actually the hero, but he's just ordinary people like you and me.
Remember Moses? He was chosen to show God's mighty power to the Pharaoh and God's people by leading them out of Egypt.
And God used Joseph to save his people from a great famine.
We already told those stories.
That's right. Did you know that hundreds of years before that, God made a promise to someone else, named Abraham? God said,
I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and the sand on the seashore. And through your offspring, all nations on earth will be blessed because you have obeyed. Genesis 22:17-18.
Thank you.
Well, that doesn't seem like I was blessed with them and showing people he was their God. Well, that people thought for a while, too.
But even though God gave a covenant to the Israelites through Abraham, the people still forgot about it when things got difficult.
And when Moses told them God could rescue them from Pharaoh, they didn't believe him because they thought God had forgotten.
But once God led the people out of Egypt by walking them through the Red Sea, they had a huge party. And I mean huge party. Moses' sister led the people in a song of praise to God that must have been heard for miles.
I will sing to the Lord for he is highly exalted.
The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him.
Today.
Sure they do. Throughout the Bible, it's the threat of God's love and faithfulness to his people through him.
Or I didn't understand what was going on.
Even when they forgot about the amazing things God had just done for them.
What does that have to do with us?
Well, we may not be Israelites, but we are God's people.
What do you mean?
When God sent Jesus down to earth so many years ago, he gave us the chance to really become his children.
I'm not sure I understand.
Maybe we can talk more about it.
than any made-up story.
And God will never give up on his children.
Now, if you will all sit back and be drawn to the legs inside the boat, we are ready to cast off and finish our mighty power of the cruise. God, with these new stories, can